I have the responsibility that I consider a sacred responsibility to introduce Kelli Seals-Obazee. Kelli runs the Dallas Peace Center, which is very sacred to me and very special in my heart. When I first came to Dallas, the Dallas Peace Center was located right down the street from the Southern Christian Leadership Conference office, which was Forest Avenue at that time. It's Martin Luther King Boulevard now. The Peace Center was located in Mark Herbner's old church, Mount Olive Lutheran, upstairs. So I've had this long 40-year history with the Dallas Peace Center. And nobody could be as thrilled as I am that the Dallas Peace Center has an African-American woman directing the Dallas Peace Center.
Bravo. Right. Bravo.
And she has a powerful message. We traveled together to Arizona, to Phoenix, to picket that sheriff down there in Phoenix, and I had a great time with her and with her whole family. Give you a great welcome to Kelli Seals-Obazee, head of the Dallas Peace Center.
All right.
Thank you, Dad. I really appreciate you. I do consider this man my father in the struggle for his years of experience and dedication and the years in which he has just willingly given his life. And Mother, you stood by him the whole time. God bless you. May God continue to bless you and keep you both. This issue of state-sponsored killing is an issue that troubles us all deeply. Because the question is, after all, where does it stop? Where does it stop? If we are willing to put to death our own citizens of this country, regardless of the crime or if they're innocent at all, when death is an option for your own citizens, how much more for those abroad? The callousness of our heart conditions in continuing to support the death penalty should cause us all to pause and seriously reflect. Are we doing enough? What are we doing in our everyday life to commit to abolishing the death penalty and restoring humanity and true justice from our government to those of us who are citizens who walk on this street? We've got to be more than willing to come to an occasional protest. We've got to continuously to speak out on this issue and share with our comrades, our friends, our constituencies, and yes, even our families. I had a very interesting conversation with my own mother. Oh, it's just as easy enough to murder them. When there is a valid option that preserves life, it makes me wonder how much we value our own lives. When the lady who spoke and had us connect arms, that's how I see each and every one of us, completely connected. And what affects you and yours affects me and mine. And the same vigilant justice and safety and security that I am willing to stand and fight for is the same that I know my brother will do for me. This is what makes us human. We need nothing short than a human revolution in this country, starting with myself, starting with you, and you, and you, and the babies, and all of us. We need a new consciousness to understand without any question or consideration that we are all one family, black, white, Chinese, Greek, Hebrew, it doesn't matter. We are all one family. And the only way that we as a society, as a human race, will continue to survive and thrive is once we recognize and grasp that and live that out, that truth in our daily lives. That justice for you has got to be justice for me. Security for you has got to be security for me. So when Texas, of all places, with all of its horrific crimes to humanity, its wars of weaponry that's made in our backyard, the continued death executions taking place on a regular basis, both at home and abroad, I would ask you, are you, the 50 of us that are here, are you doing enough? What more can you do? Challenge yourself. Challenge yourself. Challenge yourself. What more could you do to create peace? The peace and security we all long for, the peace and security we all deserve, the human rights and civil rights we all long for, and we all deserve. Think about it. And if you're not doing enough, and if you feel like there's more you can do, contact the Dallas Peace Center, contact the NAACP, contact the LULAC, contact Rick. We've got to be all about each other's business, without question, all the time. God bless you all.
Yeah. Right. Yeah, right.